In this video, we're checking back in on the Falcon and Winter Soldier spec books. Looks like people love their costumes. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to another video with Swagglehoss. And in this video, we're checking back in on the Falcon and Winter Soldier spec books to see where they are in the market. Now, we've had a couple episodes so far, and there's been a lot of interesting reveals, and that's had its mark for sure on the market in terms of the values of certain books. But there's also been a couple corrections, which I also thought was really, really interesting. But we're gonna pull up our list, take a look together, and kind of see where we are, you know, compared to a couple weeks ago, and you know, kind of talk about what some of the new books that are really, really interesting and hot right now based on the reveals we got in the last couple episodes. But before I get into the market stuff, if you guys could drop me a like or a comment or subscribe if you're enjoying my content, love interacting with you guys, help support the channel, do one of those things, and I would appreciate it. All right, that said, let's take a look at some of the books here. And again, let me pull this up for you guys. If you remember, I had this market sheet that I put together here with a bunch of the numbers. I call it my napkin math. But before we get into like the number specifics, you know, these are some of the books that we were talking about. Captain America 323, of course, the first appearance of John Walker. There was Captain America 354, which was also the first appearance of the US agent. Additionally, we had Captain America 168, first appearance of Baron Zemo. Compared to Captain America 275, which is the first appearance of Baron Zemo in costume, which is a really, really interesting thing to talk about in this video today. Additionally, I wanted to also kind of talk about Captain America 312, which is the first appearance of the Flag Smasher, and also Truth, Red, White, and Black, number one, which is the first appearance of Isaiah Bradley. So this one's a really, really interesting one to talk about in today's video. But let's get into the market here. Again, I also had the first Falcon in Captain America costume. That one I'm not going to talk about because we haven't gotten that kind of reveal yet. So there has not necessarily been a spike in the numbers, but definitely something I'm keeping my eye on, and we will see what happens when and if we get that reveal. But let's talk about Captain America 323 first. This is the first appearance of John Walker. And I think that so far of all of the books that have had, you know, an impact in based on Falcon and Winter Soldier, outside of course, Falcon's first appearance and Winter Soldier's first appearance, this feels like the book that has been the most relevant to the storyline so far. Wyatt Russell playing John Walker, the new Captain America, has had sort of the biggest storyline. And as a result, you know, we've kind of seen this book consistently be sought after within the market. Although, with that said, it is interesting to see here that, you know, here we are early 2021. We saw average raw for this book was around $38.85. Then 1 week before the show, last time we did a video, the average raw kind of spiked up to 8103, which was 100% gain in terms of the value. But here we are 2 weeks after, and actually there's been a slight correction. Average raw 74.70, which is down 8%. But you know, that I don't think that really says much to me. Again, you know, how am I arriving at these numbers? I'm pulling up all of the eBay sales, all of the eBay listings, and just doing the math myself. So, you know, again, there's margin for error in this. You know, there's also, you know, sales that are not just eBay that are happening. And so overall, 8% down, I feel like, generally speaking, is well within the average that you were seeing 2 weeks ago. So overall, I would argue that this book, generally speaking, has kept its value for the most part. But what's really interesting here is if you look at the CGCs, the 9.8, you see early here in the year, the 9.8 was selling at $400. Then 1 week before the show, we saw a sale for $700, which is up 75% in terms of its value. Now, 2 weeks after, that CGC 9.8 is still climbing. We saw a recent sale of $900. So again, up 23%. So this is really interesting here because this book overall, you know, and that makes sense to me overall, because, you know, if you talk about the average raws, like that number is going to have a fluctuation based on, you know, what the sale of the thing of the day is, what the grade is out there that people are buying. You know, it's going to be up and down. Maybe someone listed a bunch of low grades, so the numbers are swayed in that way. So there's going to be room for error in this. But, you know, when you track the CGC 9.8, there is no room for error in that. That is the market speaking for itself. And as far as this book is concerned, the market continues to want to get their hands on this. And there's been a growth in terms of the CGC 9.8. So that one is really, really interesting there. And I only imagine that as we get continued episodes throughout the weeks, that this one will continue to go up so long as Wyatt Russell is playing the new Captain America. All right, let's go on now to this one here, Captain America 354. And this one is obviously tangentially related to the Wyatt Russell character, John Walker. And this is when John Walker becomes the U.S. agent. Now, as far as the show has kind of rolled out so far, we don't necessarily see any signs that, you know, John Walker is going to become the U.S. agent. This is speculation based on the fact that, you know, we know what happens in the comic books. But, you know, taking a look at the show and just sort of stepping back, it feels like if they're going to do the U.S. agent storyline, it feels like this is going to be a tease reveal at the very, very, very end of the show. So for that reason, this feels like we're probably not going to see this specific rendition of the character, at least until, you know, many, many weeks from now. So I kind of compare this right now to like the White Vision equivalent for WandaVision, where, you know, leading up to the show, there was some anticipation that we might get White Vision. And as the weeks kind of progressed, people sort of, you know, pulled away from the White Vision book. And then as we got that reveal, which was in, you know, the second to last episode, that's when the book really, really took a jump. So I feel like a similar thing is happening here with Captain America 354, where we see this book, you know, it actually has a correction here. And you can see here, so average raw earlier in the year, $25, went up to 76 right before the show, a 200% increase. And now the average raw is back down to $54. So been an 18% decrease overall. And I think that's because, you know, people are seeing, or they're not seeing it. They're not seeing the instant gratification, the reward of seeing a U.S. agent on the screen. So there's been a correction in that sense. But I think, you know, if you're still someone out there who's anticipating that we're going to get U.S. agent in some kind of way later on the show, I think that U.S. agent will be the White Vision of Falcon and Winter Soldier. You can bet that this number will jump back up. Similarly, in the CGC 9.6s, which, you know, there wasn't a 9.8 I was able to track, you can see here 120 before the show, 510 leading up to the show, and now there's been a correction here, 380 CGC 9.6. So that's down 25%. So again, because we haven't seen U.S. agent specifically yet, you know, in costume, that book has had a correction. All right, let's go on now here to the next couple of books, and that's going to be Captain America 168 and Captain America 275. And if you guys saw the last video I did for this type of series where, you know, we're analyzing the spec books, these ones I kind of talked about hand in hand because, you know, this is the first appearance of Zemo, but then this is the first appearance of Zemo in costume. And so the trends for these books have been actually really, really interesting because 168, you see here, let me just back this up. 168, the average raw at the beginning of the year was $25. It spiked up before the show to $65. And even though we got the reveal that Zemo is coming in this next coming episode, we've actually had a correction with this particular book, 168, back down to 37.50. So that's a minus, you know, 43%. Again, there's always like room for error within the calculations based on what's being sold out there. But, you know, I think it's interesting to me, as I mentioned sort of in the intro of this video, that this seems to be the book that people are actually moving away from. And 275, as I'll get into the numbers there, seems to be the winner book that is coming up because, you know, again, people really love their costumes. Even though this is the first appearance of Zemo, I think people want to see Zemo in that purple hood, which leads us to 275. You know, if we look at the numbers here, 275 at the, you know, average raw, like leading up to the show, I did the calculation, it was around 27.35, and average raw now for this book is actually 50.12. So we're up 117%. And this is also like a, you know, a $20 margin for this book compared to 168. So I think that that's really interesting that this particular book here, 275, is slowly starting to take off. It's slowly starting to gain ground on 168. And actually, that's not what I would have anticipated to happen, because to me, 168 is the first appearance. I would think that you would just want the first appearance, but hey, people love their costumes. And I think, you know, if we get Zemo in this coming episode where he dons the purple hood, or, you know, maybe in the next week after that, he's going to don the purple hood. When that moment happens, I really think 275 is going to take off again. And we're going to have, you know, a huge spike in this book. And that's probably going to leave 168 in the dust, because once the numbers for 275 become really high, and this is like kind of the market determines that, hey, this is the Zemo book. This is now the Zemo book. We think that we want to chase this one. We don't care that it's not his first appearance. We care that he's the first, you know, costume appearance of him. After that becomes the case, I think that 168 you know, as far as a key is concerned, it'll almost never be the same. I think 275 will be the Zemo book from here on out. But that's my prediction as of now. Let me know what you guys think. All right, the last couple of books I want to talk about here are Captain America 312 and Truth, Red, White, and Black. Number one, which, you know, Captain America 312, this is the first appearance of a character known as the Flag Smasher. And we can see that, you know, in the show, we've got some, you know, version of Flag Smasher. We didn't get the very specific character that was in the sort of Mark Gruenwald storyline, but we did get sort of a different interpretation of it. Carly Montague, I think, is her name. So I think, you know, similarly, people are still wanting to get their hands on this book. You know, it's definitely seen sort of like a overall a 20% increase in terms of its value. But, you know, I kind of equate this to Ghost that we saw in Ant-Man 2, where that book certainly did take a jump, but because the character isn't a one-to-one character that we're seeing from book to screen, I think that has hurt this book a little bit. I still think it's a desirable collector item and the market still wants to get their hands on it, but, you know, it's not going to reach those same values that a book like, you know, Captain America 323 is going to reach. Similarly, a book like Truth, Red, White, and Black, which is the first appearance of Isaiah Bradley. So we saw that scene with Isaiah Bradley, the older superhero that Falcon and Winter Soldier visited, it's inferred that, you know, he's going to continue to play a role the coming weeks, in the coming plot as we get it and try to discover where the super soldiers are coming from. And this book is really interesting to me because this is the book that's actually, you know, I've seen had the most growth overall, you know, which is surprising that even with the 323s and 168 and 275, the other Captain America stuff, that's had some, you know, market growth. But Truth, Red, White, and Black, this is the one that I feel like, you know, people are super, super excited about this book. Because when I dig into the numbers here, you can see average raw is now around sort of the $75 mark. And that's compared to where it was, say, you know, before the show began, which the average raw was around that sort of $25, $30 mark. So, you know, overall, this is like a 300% increase, which is kind of crazy because, you know, I personally didn't know too much about this character before because I had never read that specific comic book storyline. And I would have thought that, you know, the characters from the older, like Bronze Age and Silver Age and things like that would be sort of like the books that people actively chase. But this one has really, really captured, you know, the market's attention and really, really gotten people excited about that character. Maybe it's the portrayal of him or, you know, how much, like, you know, hurt and pain he looked like he went through. And people are really excited to see where his storyline goes. So, that's really interesting. Truth, Black, Red, White, and Black, number one, has been almost like the biggest winner book so far in the market. Anyways, that is all I have for this video. Let me know what you guys think. Have you guys, you know, picked up any of these books? What other books have you been hunting based on Falcon and Winter Soldier? How do you like the show so far compared to WandaVision? I've really, really been enjoying it. It feels like we're getting that sort of Marvel show, whereas WandaVision was great. It was a different kind of thing, I'm happy that we're kind of back in sort of the quote-unquote Marvel universe with a more sort of typical, I guess, superhero plotline. Anyways, that's all I have for this video. Drop me a like, comment, or subscribe, and I will see you in the next one.